All of that YOLOing can make a man thirsty, so I decided to meet up with Chef Ronal to learn a few things about the local ingredients, as well as pick up some tips on how to construct the perfect Pisco Sour.
The black and the yellow, yeah? Chekche, chulpin, yeah? Those are tastes, very tasty. Even if you visit some bars, I'm sure that they're gonna give you very salty. The white one, the red one, and the yellow one, those, my friends, were used for boiled, but also to make the chicha, the fermented drink, yeah? In the process of the chicha, the people live to germinate, and after boil, and live to fermentate, yeah, okay? And the Incas drink more chicha than water, guys. Why? Yes, because the Incas knew that wasn't a good idea to drink water from the mountains. For example, you're gonna make some tricks. The water there looks clear, you know, but the animals drink from there, yeah, and has small parasites. Yeah, so be careful, yeah?
That's, sorry, I think that's the same as like in the Middle Ages, they drank a lot more beer than water because everyone's getting sick from the water.
It's the same here, man. Yeah. This is the same, yeah? Actually, the Incas' bodies was very delicate. When the Spaniards came to here, they broke many illnesses, you know? And most of the people died for the illnesses, knowing to the words. That's why. That's why the Spaniards broke slaves from Africa to work here, because many people died here, actually. Yeah? The big one is to make drinks. For example, let me remember the Pisco Sour, okay? And the small one is to make ceviche, my friends. Actually, I have to buy this for you. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna buy this for you.
So. Is there a difference in the flavor between the big and the small?
Very good. This one, it doesn't have seeds inside, yeah? So it's a little bit bitter, but nicer. With the alcohol is perfect, yeah? But this one is more sour. So for cook or salads, it's much better. Yeah, I'm gonna buy this for you.
During our time at the market, I began to hear whispers of a very intriguing breakfast dish, the elusive caldo de cabeza, or sheep's head soup, where a sheep's head is cleaved in half, stewed in a pot with turnip, parsley, and other tasty ingredients. I felt compelled to give it a try. With breakfast ending at 11 o'clock, I had to make a quick detour. Unfortunately for this segment, I forgot to turn on my microphone, so I'll dub in what I was actually saying in the moment. Something spicy. Looks like a salsa. And some lime. Perfect for this type of fare. I'm excited about this dish, actually. Really, I think it could be something interesting. Put some of this spicy stuff in there. Let's try some of this sheep's head. It was around this moment that I suspected they may have left the brains in the soup. So I called over the proprietor and asked him my best Spanish, which it turns out is terrible Spanish, and he thought I was asking for more brains. So he brought over a fresh one and plopped it cold into my soup. Of course, me being a man of integrity and impeccable decorum could not refuse such an offer. A little cerebral cortex to stimulate the morning appetite? Some lukewarm animal custard. It's actually perfect for the morning, so. All right, let's try a bit of this brain. Pretty good. Ah, look at that there. I'm finding the viscosity ensconcing my teeth and gums to be particularly pleasant. You know? It's like liver pate, only more intelligent. Let's try a bit more. Interesting texture. Nothing weird about it at all, though. My new fave. After getting some brains, I stepped outside for a recap of the action. It was around this moment I realized that I forgot to turn my mic on. Hello, immediately, I began to feel like a porn star after her first DP scene, being told that there was a problem with the cameras during the filming and all of the footage had been lost. I felt used, damaged, a deep trauma from which I might never recover. At this point, the only thing that might save me from a spiraling depression was strong drink. Time to find Chef Ronal.
I'll explain to you everything about Pisco, but first we're going to mix the ingredients, yeah? The ingredients are Pisco, of course. Yeah, have to be Peruvian. because other country has pisco, guys. Yeah, which country? Chile.
Yeah, my reference point for the flavor of this, it reminded me of mezcal or tequila.
Yeah.
And I was surprised when I heard it was made from grapes.
Ah, this one? Yeah, yeah. Actually, it tastes like tequila, guys. A little bit. Yeah. Yes, guys. It's because we burned the grapes to activate the yeast a little bit before. It's like a little process. Looks like it sounds like wine a little bit.
Yeah.
Come on, Cliff, your turn. Yeah. You want maybe one extra clip or it's okay for us?
Sure.
Okay. That's it. Go ahead. Okay, we'll give you a little bit more, yeah?
Francis?
Even we have a crazy pisco sour with 6 ounces, guys, yeah? The name is Cathedral Pisco Sour. It's just
cathedral?
For
Cathedral? What does that mean?
Cathedral means the big church, the main
like cathedral. Cathedral.
Yes, yeah. Cathedral. Yeah, it's crazy. Cathedral. It's just drunk people like it, guys. In Lima, you're gonna find it, yeah? Here, I've never saw. Yeah, you have to drink quick. Yeah, it's insane. Yeah, now 1 ounce, please.
And why do you have to drink it quick?
Because that says the tradition, you know. Oh. People drink because they don't have too much time for the pisco, so they have to drink it quick. It's too strong. I was in Lima, I drank it once and I was sleeping.
I thought maybe it's quick, they do it while God's not watching.
Yes, maybe. Yes, maybe. Yes.
1 ounce?
1 ounce, please. Very good. Everything there? Nice. Mm-hmm. Perfect, guys. Yeah. Now I will now explain to you everything about the pisco history, guys. 500 years ago, the Spaniards brought the grapes to make pisco to here to Peru. Yeah. The first place where the Spaniards made wine was here in Cuzco. Yeah. For the religion, because Cuzco was very important, you know. So also for the commerce. But what was the problem here? The earth is too rich. So the wine was too sweet. Sweet wine is not good for the commerce, guys, and turns vinegar. So that's why they look for other place, dry, you know, better to make the wine. They found a place 4 hours from Lima, the capital, and named it Pisco, guys. It was a small village long time ago, okay? There was the first production of the spirit of this, distillated drink, and also the wine, guys, yeah? Okay, now. The original name of the pisco was agua ardiente, the uva, amigos, yeah? Yeah, an American made it first, they drink pisco sour, guys, yeah? Okay, the story says that in one bar in Lima, named Morris Bar, close to the Hotel Bolivar, is there the place, the owner, in that time, the whiskey over, and instead of use whiskey, they use pisco, yeah? So, the pisco sour is a copy of the whiskey sour, guys, yeah? That's the story says. But the pisco sour was the second famous drink in base pisco. The first one was the pisco punch. Yeah?
Pisco punch.
Yes, very popular even today in San Francisco, guys. Yeah, the pisco punch is pisco, orange juice, this is pineapple juice as well, and lime juice, and that's it. It's very tasty as well. It's very good.
A ver.
Okay, dale ahora. Fuerte. Strong. Very good. Now, guys, you have to take it like this and make circles on this one. 40 seconds, please, with all your forces. 40 segundos. Vamos, amigos. 3, 2, 1, stop, guys. But a good pisco sour always have to be made into the shaker. So, in many places, okay, it's prohibited to use the blender, guys. If you are paying 30 soles, for example, for one drink, the barman have to use their hands, yeah? Better to tell you now, yeah? Okay, that's it. So.
That's a good job.
Yeah, you've got a good technique.
Okay. All the piscos sours have to go in these glasses. The name is Quero Glass and represents the glass of the Inca, guys. Yeah, okay? That's it. Wait. Second.
I don't think I've ever poured a cocktail before, to be honest.
Yes. It's fine, it's fine. Put it there. More, more, more. Stop. Now small circles. Very good. Pour it. More, more, more. Stop. Now quick, with all your forces. Pour it all of it. Come on. Nice. That's it, guys. Yeah, okay. This is the technique to get a good pisco sour. Yeah, now the decoration, the most important. Yeah.
Una, dos y tres. Yeah.
Esto representa a la trilogía andina, amigos. Ya en el Perú se adora mucho a tres dioses: el puma, el cóndor y la serpiente. Ya, y eso representa las tres gotas.
¿Qué es eso? ¿Cómo sabe?
Esto sabe como Jägermeister, ¿sabes? Pero el Jägermeister está hecho con semillas, no con raíces.
Cáscara de naranja.
¿Ya? Muy bien. Salud, salud, salud. Perfecto.
Needless to say, my Pisco Sour was excellent, and it got my mind right for my continued foray into the unknown. On the next episode of Food Rhymes in Life, I will conclude my travels in Peru, but not before visiting Machu Picchu, Arequipa, Nazca, and lastly, a more thorough outing in the capital city of Lima. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next one. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, documenting food rhymes in life around the globe.